have our half rack series equipment stuff, which include our V5, our U5, and our M5, which is over here on the other side in black.
This one's new here, right?
No, sir, it's not. The M5 has been out for quite a long time. As what we did a while ago when we had our
new.
The V5 is new, yes, sir. We'll talk about that in a minute. But when we did our anniversary edition, we did a production run of black units, or units with a black faceplate. Because it was so popular, we decided that we can now offer any of our units in a black faceplate or a silver faceplate. Underneath the hood, it's the same electronics, it's the same no compromise transistors, transformers, vacuum tubes, and so forth, but we do offer these options. Getting back to our half rack series, we have the M5 at the top here, which the M5 is a mic free. It does have a filter on it, so if you want to roll off the low end, because you may have air conditioned noise and all of that, you know, low end rumble in your recording that you don't need, you can roll it off. It's a variable filter. It has the ability to work as a direct box as well. So we do have a high impedance input in the back that you can plug your guitars into, and it runs like a standard microphone. The M5 is also set up to run 130 volt mics that you'd find from B&K. We don't get people doing that often with it, but it does have the plugs and the ability to do so. Moving down to the bottom here, we have our U5, which is a direct box. You will find more U5s out in the world than any other direct box on the market. You'll find it in recording studios, you'll find it on stage. You'll find it just about anywhere. Nathan East has two of them in his bass rig. Marcus Miller stopped by yesterday to tell us that his bass tech snuck one under his rig when he was touring Japan recently. And he's like, I don't know what happened, but my rig just started sounding better. And I finally found out it was you guys, so I wanted to come by and say hi and say thank you. This is a very unique box in the fact it's got a 6-position filter switch on it, which does 6 different resistor capacitor filters to shape your tone. It also has a boost function on it so you can get a little louder. It has the ability to be bass input, guitar input, whatever. It's another high impedance that has a throughput also, so you can come out of here and go to your amplifier. You can, if you wanted to, set it up to where your tone functions and your boost functions are running out the throughput as well. So if you get a tone that you really like say, in this case, number 4 is really popular with a lot of bass players, you can have that coming out of here going to your amplifier as well as part of your live sound. In the back of the unit, it's got a line level connection, so you can go directly out into your recording rig or your mixing console. It has a mic level out, so you can go, again, into a console and boost it up with the preamp if you want to add different tonality. The other thing that really makes the U5 unique is it can be a speaker load. So if you have, for example, we get a lot of guys, they have an Aguilar like Tone Hammer or other bass heads that they really like, but they're playing church gigs where they can't be as loud as they want to be. So they have their, you know, bass head on stage, and they're able to run this as a speaker load into their PA system that they're using for their worship services. So this has been around for a long time, as has the M5, and they've done really well for us over the years. But a couple of years ago, we decided to start getting into new ventures, which is where we came up with the idea for the V5. Our V5 is a reamp box, or at least that's what it started off as. But like everything else at Avalon, we like to go over the top with everything. So we went from doing a reamp box to a box that allows you to work as a direct input, it allows you to work as a line amplifier, and allows you to work as a microphone preamp as well, depending on how you have it connected. We borrowed some ideas from our U5, we borrowed some ideas from our M5. But this box is completely different. It uses the same Class A discrete technology that we're known for, but the way it's designed gives it a different sonic and different character. You'll note on the tone position in particular, on the tone switch, there's 1 through 6, which are the same filter positions as the U5. Where this differs is we have 2 more positions on the low side and 2 positions on the high side that offer you the option to do a high pass filter or low cut. And on the high side, we have the option to boost a little bit of the high end with it, which is pretty cool.
It is.
This also has a built-in headphone amplifier. So if you want to sit and jam with yourself at night, you can do that. The U5 has the headphone amplifier as well. As I said, you can reamp with this. So you can go in at line level and come out at instrument level. You can use this as a line amp, so you can go in at line level and come out at line level. And you could also, again, use it as a mic read. So you can go in with your microphones. This will handle any microphone under the sun in terms of volume. So in some cases, like where you're working with Ribbon microphones, and people are like, well, it's not enough gain. This is more than enough gain to drive a good Ribbon, a passive Ribbon or active Ribbon. This will drive any microphone, it sounds really good. And one of the best features to this is the fact that the power distribution on it is a bit asymmetrical, much like the old Neve equipment was. So the Neve 1073 series or the 10 series that everybody loves so much, that you can hit into different points of distortion because of its power supply rails and how they distribute throughout the unit. We have a similar character kind of thing going on because it's an asymmetrical power feed. It's not balanced where it's like bipolar back and forth. It's a single. So this has done us really well, but it is our newest in our production line. It's about 2 years old.